Hey everybody, it's Meredith Miller with Inner Integration, and today the topic I have for you is projection, the narcissist's weapon that can be used against them. So I'm going to talk about what the narcissist is doing with projection, what it's actually revealing to you, and how you can use that against them by understanding what their true motives are. Essentially, all narcissists tell on themselves. Projection is the process through which they reveal who they are and what they're doing. Through projection, they call you what they are. They accuse you of doing what they're doing or planning on doing. They throw their uncomfortable feelings onto you because they don't want to deal with them. They throw their shame onto you so they don't have to deal with it. They make you feel guilty for who they are and what they're doing because they are unable to feel that guilt themselves. So essentially, projection is an unconscious way of denying the existence of something inside oneself and attributing it to others, right? Externalizing it. So this can be unacceptable or unwanted characteristics, flaws, thoughts, emotions, actions, feelings. It's a defense mechanism. So, you know, anybody can do this. You can be projecting things onto people and not even realize it. There's going to be one thing I talk about at the end too when I give you a few tips. That's a very common form of projection among codependents, people pleasers, empaths. But in the case of the narcissist, what they're doing with this projection is because they are unable to see these things inside themselves, they have to project it on other people. Because they're unable to be accountable and responsible for their stuff, they have to project it onto other people. So projection is like a combination of misdirection and blame shifting you. So they're diverting and distracting you from what's really going on. And they're getting you to take responsibility for it in some way on the surface, right? That's what they seem to think is going on. But if you learn to read the narcissist instead of just taking everything personally, you're going to see how valuable their projections are for revealing who they are and what they're doing. So I'm going to give you some common examples. You're probably going to relate to some of these, and it's probably going to get you thinking about other ways that you've seen this taking place. So examples of projection in narcissists, where the narcissist accuses you of cheating and goes on and on about questioning you, what you were doing and who you were with and what's going on, and they're all up in your stuff because the narcissist is cheating or planning on it. The narcissist says at the restaurant, "Where's our plump dumpling waitress?" But the narcissist is overweight. The narcissist calls you up and says, "Did you hear about so-and-so? I heard she has a lot of darkness going on." But the narcissist is a very dark character. You set a boundary and you don't give the narcissist what he or she wants, so the narcissist calls you selfish. The narcissist accuses you of lying because the narcissist is a pathological liar. The narcissist's business partner says to you, "What have you been doing for the last 6 months? You built the entire business in the last 6 months. The narcissist did nothing but surf the internet, travel, and schmooze people." So you see how they're just externalizing and throwing onto you or whomever the target is, whatever they're unable to face or don't like inside themselves. So I'm going to give you a couple tips on how to deal with the projection. The very first one is don't identify with it. When you identify with the projection, that becomes projection identification. I mentioned that in a Q&A video I did a few months ago. So remember, that's about them, not about you, whatever they're saying. Now, often it'll be direct to you. Sometimes it might just be about someone else like the waitress or someone else in the background. But try not to get upset about that. Try not to give a reaction. Try not to get involved in any kind of narcissistic supply giving. But remember, don't internalize the projection. If it's aimed towards you, don't internalize it and don't make it yours. When you don't take it personally, that's when you can see the reveal taking place outside. But if you're taking it too personally, you're not going to see what they're revealing. You're just going to get caught up in that. It's essentially your ego that's going to get caught up in that. So remember, tell your ego to take a seat. Don't take it personally. And just look at the whole scenario at the big picture and recognize, what are they telling you? What are they revealing to you about their motives, what their plans are, or what they're actually doing? Another tip is don't project your own good qualities onto anyone else. And this is the one that empaths, codependents, people pleasers do, right? We projected our empathy, our generosity, our honesty, all the good qualities that we wanted to see in our mate or in our boss and our friend and our family member, whomever, right? That it was. But those were our qualities. We were projecting our goodness onto them. Those things weren't actually there. We just wanted to see those things in them. We wanted to believe in those qualities in that person. And finally, know yourself and be assertive in your sense of self. Because if you know yourself, when the narcissist is projecting these things at you and you're not taking it personally, you're going to be like, nope, that's not me. So you're going to be able to laugh that off. You're going to be able to just let that go and realize that's not personal at all. That's definitely a projection. So be assertive in your sense of self. Know who you are, know yourself, and be assertive in your sense of self. Assertive in owning your reality so the narcissist can't get away with that projection. Remember, you can use this to your advantage in situations where you have to deal with the narcissist, especially when you're trying to figure out what their next move is or what's going on. Listen to them because they always tell on themselves. So if you've got a comment to add to this, the short scenario that you had a projection, an example to share with somebody, go ahead and share that because that could be really helpful. Maybe sometimes people are reflecting on what was the projection and what were they saying, and they read your example and then it triggers some kind of memory of something that happened for them. It could be really helpful. So remember, you can use this against them. You don't have to let it be a weapon used against you. I'm sending you all a big hug.